This is the last video on the chapter Business Environment Demonetization. I've taken this topic right now because after doing the reforms of 1991, that is about LPG, impact and managerial responses, this was the latest reform which happened in 2016. Our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, he initiated this on 8 November 2016. And what do we exactly mean by demonetization and what was the reason and what all demonetization when we talk about it, the history, how many times it has happened in India. So in India, it has happened for three times, once in 1946, the other time in 1978 and third time in 2016. When it happened in 48 and 76, the intention was to curb the black money. And in 2016, again, the intention was to curb the black money along with many other reasons. What exactly do we mean by demonetization? Demonetization means whenever a country withdraws the usage of a legal tender in circulation, it leads to demonetization. It can be a note, it can be a coin, it can be a precious metal, anything. Now, what is legal tender? Legal tender, like for example, in India, we have our currency in kind of notes. And the value to it is given by the government. So when the government withdraws that value, it is known as that the legal tender is no more in circulation. So we start with demonetization. Demonetization, when was it initiated? 8th November 2016, and which notes were demonetized? 500 and 1000 currency notes were banned. Instead of that, new notes of 500 and 2000 were initiated. In India, it has happened twice before, like I've told you, history. So we're talking about date, we're talking about history. Once in 46, once in 78. Janata government initiated it. And notes of 1,000, 5,000, 10,000 were banned. Of course, the intention was to curb the black money. Now, purpose was to curb practice of Benami properties as well as to curb tax evasion. This was at this time when in 2016, the government wanted to initiate demonetization. What exactly we mean by sometimes, you know, I've not written out here, but even some of there's a notion that some kind of black money was being given to support the terrorist activities. So when we talk about Benami properties, people were buying properties, did not know who was buying and how it was being bought because it was not being done in white, it was all being done in black. So we wanted to curb that practice also. And a lot of tax evasion was going on. People were not paying their kind of sales tax, their income tax. So that kind of money was also to be curbed down. That practice had to be curbed down. Now, definition is to withdraw coin, like I told you, note or a precious metal to be used as a legal tender. So immediately after the demonetization, the effect was seen was that people, a long queue of people was there, and people were standing outside banks and ATMs, and they wanted the new currency note. It was not printed immediately, it took some time. And when people were trying to get small currency notes of 150, that also posed a very big threat to the people. So immediate effect was of 2016 demonetization was that prolonged cash shortages, a lot of cash shortages was there. Then it created disruption throughout the economy because immediately the production stopped. People could not pay and give except for essential commodities like petroleum and some hospital bills, utility bills. Rest of the things were not, the old currency was not accepted for rest of the things. The Sensex went down, it fell over to 6%, and BSE, NSE, Nifty 50 went down by 6%. It reduced the country's industrial production and GDP growth rate also, it went down. And along with that, what happened, to what extent did we have demonetization? Now exactly, were we successful in curbing down the black money? According to RBI, they say that around 15.5 trillion, that is 86.9% of the total currency in circulation was actually deposited into the bank. Really, we are not sure that were we able to or were we successful in curbing the black money. But yes, few things happened immediately. So this was the immediate effect and this was the extent of demonetization. Now, what exactly the features of demonetization say? First, it was tax administrative measure. They say that it was done to administrate the tax. People, what they started doing was they started depositing cash in hand into the bank. Immediately they went to the bank, they started depositing the cash, and they wanted new currency in lieu of the old currency. Those who had black money had to declare cash and pay taxes. You would not believe that many times media covered that people were giving a lot of donations to the religious places and a lot of donation went to the hospitals. It is just a media hype that people who had a lot of black money, they got account open for their employees where they deposited 2 lakh rupees per person. And lot many those kind of practices happened, but that was again not successful. Those who actually went to the bank and deposited their money and paid tax with penalty were the people who saved their money. So first was tax administrative measure. Second was tax evasion control. Now what was happening was people were trying to evade the tax, not paying taxes on time, or they were not at all paying taxes. So ultimately when everything became very transparent and things became very clear, people had to deposit tax. So that problem of tax evasion was actually eroded. Malpractices of tax evasion was now controlled. That is, tax evasion will no longer be tolerated. People had to deposit their money, show everything. Even everyone had to, link up their accounts with their Aadhaar cards, and you could not have more than one bank account. If you had two accounts, then it was Aadhaar enabled. So a lot of practices were at that time imposed on people. Now, formal financial system was channelized. Actually, India did not have a formal financial system. People used to keep their money at home. They used to keep their money in their lockers. They did not declare their money, their income directly to the government. So actually tax evasion was there. Now, a formal system was channelized. How? Saving of people were put into formal system. Why? Because people had to be financially dependent on the bank. The old currency was no more in circulation. As a result, new deposits were created. People started creating new deposits. I just gave you an example. New property, new profitable schemes were launched. This was done by the government of India as well as the banks. They started giving the new schemes. Why? They said if you deposit for this much time, you will get this much of rate of interest. And of course, everything was accounted for. Encouraging to provide loan at low rate. They said the more deposits banks will have, bank will be able to provide the loans at lower rate of interest. So a kind of formal financial system was immediately initiated. Now the economy became less cash economy. If we talk about less cash economy, around 2016, people were using a different kind of digital wallets. There was PayPal, there were other online internet banking, but not to a very great extent because there were two problems. One was internet and the other was the internet enabled cell phones. Now, what happened with the demonetization? Every transaction started happening online. Paytm was there, but people had not got their KYC done. They did not know your customer, that identification was not done. So people started doing that also. Paytm, and then you have BHIM and PayPal and Google Pay. Lot many these kind of system of online transaction started. It was a big hubbub for people when they used to talk about how can people keep money in digital form, you know. But then with these kind of apps coming up on your mobile phones, it became easy to go on for the transactions. Also, point of sale terminals, your credit cards and debit cards were swiped for doing the transaction or buying and selling or purchase of anything. So a formal financial economy system was elaborated. In spite of limitations of non-availability of internet and cell phones, POS machines, that is point of sale terminals, जिसमें आप कार्ड swipe करते हैं, Paytm digital transaction system was set up, like I gave you other example also. So these were the features of demonetization. Now demonetization also had impact on different areas, which we are going to discuss next. Next we come to impact of demonetization. Impact of demonetization, that there are few points. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points. And they lay emphasis what exactly happened after demonetization. Let's start with money interest rate. We have partly discussed this already, but then I would like to lay emphasis. There was decline in cash transaction. Very true. People did not have enough money. They were standing in long queues to get their money exchanged. So there was a difficulty. Bank deposit increase. Why? Because everybody was trying to exchange their old currency with a new one, and bank was getting deposits since everybody had to declare their income, whatever it was, the intention intention was to curb the black money. People had to deposit the money, so bank deposit increased. Increase in financial savings. Since there was not enough money to spend on the luxurious items, so people started and people had not did not have enough money for the essential commodities also. So the savings increased because everything was going into the bank. So these are the points which we cover under money interest rates. All right, next point is private wealth. Now what happened with private wealth? See, there was decline in the buying of the properties. Why? Because the intention was to curb the Benami properties. People were buying properties, did not know who was owning them, and there were people who were NRIs. They were putting their money into India, buying properties, not paying wealth tax. There were so many things happening, so that kind of things had to be curbed, and all was being done and with black money. There was no white transaction happening. So declined. Why private wealth declined? Since some high demonetized notes were not returned and real estate prices fell. So people stopped buying the properties. Next, public sector wealth. Well, there was no effect. I myself have doubts about what exactly do we mean by no effect, but probably government at that time made some policies with which that there was no effect on the real public sector. So next is digitization. What effect or what impact did digitization have? Immediately digital transactions increased. We had RuPay and APS system. We had digital wallets, Paytm, BHIM. I've already given example of that. That increased. Despite of having problem with the internet as well as the cell phone facilities, people started initiating it. Internet banking also got increased. Now, real estate. The prices declined. People, like I told you here also, when you talk about Benami properties, people were not able to buy. So the price of the real estate fell down. Why? Because people stopped buying property in totality. People did not have enough money to. Tax collection increased. Why? Because there was increase in the real reason to act upon demonetization was to curb the tax evasion. So ultimately people started paying their taxes on time and they knew they would be taken on task. So there was increase in the income tax. Okay. Now, this is though not in the syllabi, but I would just like to discuss quick recap on it, that what exactly were the advantages of demonetization. So first, black money could be tracked. We were able to track it. Then a reduction in illegal activities. Like I told you, terrorist activities were reduced. Tax payment became on time. Jandhan Yojana was started by the Prime Minister, where some kind of money was being put in for the small income group people so that they could be encouraged. Some kind of help was being given. Then e-wallets and digital currency was encouraged. Getting fake currency out of circulation, it did happen. Maybe that was a short-lived advantage, but it was there because immediately fake currency could not be printed out and circulated. So for a year almost, fake currency was stopped. Then in totality, comparatively to what fake currency was there with the previous notes, there is a lesser circulation. Disadvantages. Now, the cost of currency destruction, yes. When the currency got exchanged, then when you had to print the new notes and RBI was taking a lot of initiative, army was called to check the things out there, and printing out of notes became a very big criteria. A lot of people, a lot of manpower was involved. So enough of money was being spent. Like we had to recalibrate the ATMs and the banking system. So many things were being initiated, so a lot of money was being spent. Chaos and frenzy, big queue of people standing, there was stampede, many people died also because of this. So there was a problem. Not enough black money was extracted. Yes, that's true. We keep on saying that the intention of demonetization was to curb the black money, but if you talk about reality, still, a lot of black money is with the people. People started putting it in gold, and then at that time, even buying of gold was done with the paperwork and many other things. It was again that also became Aadhaar link. Many initiatives were taken, but still, complete black money was not curbed down or extracted. Slow downing in the economy, yeah, because production was not happening, so productivity was not taking place, and that is why the economy got a slowdown. Then ATMs had to be recalibrated, like I told you, with the digital effect, and then short-term crisis for poor people. Though Jandhan Yojana was started, but then getting anything into workable mode takes a lot of time. So we end up this video, and this time we are going to do ta-da. The video is over. I'm going to give you a synopsis of this chapter in the next video.